lo único que me corre por la cabeza, los últimos 10 de ella. Tal vez podía dar un poquito más.
New developments tonight after Heber father says a stray bullet from a neighboring apartment killed his 7-year-old daughter. Well, good evening, everyone, and thanks for joining us. With Debbie Worthen, I'm Dan Rascone. It was a heartbreaking story we told you first about last night.
A 7-year-old girl innocently sleeping in her own room when a bullet comes through the wall. News specialist Garna Mejia has the latest developments on the case. And Garna, there's been a lot of confusion. The big question is, who fired the gun?
Yeah, Debbie, that's a great question, and that's something that we've been looking into all day. What it appears is that this all started with heavy drinking and a person who should not have had a handgun in the first place.
While a father grieved at the hospital, Wasatch County Sheriff's deputies worked to understand how 7-year-old Zaydanielis Rodriguez was shot while sleeping in her room Friday night.
Possibly with a gunshot. I believe it came from the commons, but I'm not sure.
Investigating deputies at the Wasatch Commons apartments in Heber say they heard a gunshot coming from a neighboring apartment when they arrived.
Will you respond to the comments, see if you can see anything there? It just looked like this shot came in from the outside of the building.
That's when deputies found and arrested three intoxicated people. Arresting documents identify the three men as 21-year-old Trevor Joe Pinter, 36-year-old Colin David Howells, and 34-year-old Christopher Robert O'Connell, with O'Connell as the prime suspect. Deputies say O'Connell and Howells admitted to mixing alcohol and prescription medication on Friday evening. Then they walked over to their friend Pinter's apartment, number 207. That's where Pinter's girlfriend Ashley and her friend Aspen allege O'Connell pulled out and waved a firearm. The women also say the two men sexually assaulted them. Then, at some point, deputies allege O'Connell and Howells left Pinter's apartment. During the investigation, deputies determined a shot was fired from apartment 205. Arresting documents indicate, quote, they located a bullet hole that had gone through the wall and bedroom of Colin, continued north through the residence and into the next apartment complex and into the child. Deputies suspect the shot was fired by O'Connell as a witness saw him holding a gun after the shooting. And deputies, quote, observed what appeared to be a firearm near his belt line and protruding from his T-shirt.
Now, in addition to manslaughter, O'Connell could also be facing a charge for having a gun as a restricted person. Now, both O'Connell and Howells have a history with alcoholism. O'Connell has been convicted at least 3 times for driving under the influence, and Howells once assaulted an officer, breaking his glasses while drunk. Pinter could face an obstruction of justice charge for lying about O'Connell having a gun.